Hello guys, Sue Jerry speaking. Welcome to JPCBI's episode number 1279. Today we're at Eric Lee Shenanigans of 1977, episode number 44. Virgery Purchase Accreditations number 4. We had this beginning 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Massachusetts. This is a YouTube channel vlog show in which video games, flash game show gameplays, along with sports and wrestling news are the norm. This is the YouTube channel vlog show of positivity, good times, and fun. This is Eric Lee Shenanigans of 1977. And now, here is the host of the show, the perpetrator of these shenanigans, Big Beefy E himself, Mr. Eric M. Lima. Thank you very much, Mr. Announcer, for that lovely intro once again. Well, hello, everyone. This is the perpetrator of the shenanigans, Big Beefy E, Eric Lima, hosting from my Big Beefy Man Cave here in New Beige, Massachusetts, a.k.a. New Bedford, Massachusetts. It's Eric Lima Shenanigans of 1977. Once again, it's episode 444.
Wow, Eric.
And this, my friends, and if I'm not mistaken, this will be the fourth episode of Virtually Purchased Acquisitions. That's right, episode four of Virtually Purchased Acquisitions, or VPAs for short.
Now, VPAs, yep.
I don't know why I call it that, because I figured I want to come up with a new name instead of saying the unboxing. Or I'm trying to be different. And that's
yes.
Of my YouTube channel is trying to be a little bit more different than others, you know, not come up with just blasé names, you know what I mean? Speaking of names, I want to give a shout out to two new subscribers, Edric Kato and John Koken, or is it Koken? I don't know. K-O-C-A-N. It's Koken. Or Kosan. Whatever, John Kosan. And Edric Kato, welcome to my on my channel. Hope you two gentlemen have a great and wonderful day. And a blessed day as well. Hope your day is more awesome than mine. And also, thank you for subscribing and supporting the show, the channel, and whatnot. And have any questions, please feel free to comment, you know. So people are wondering, okay, you got another item from Amazon, eBay, don't you? That I do.
Yep.
I have it here in my hands, in under the, is it Lord of the Rings DVD? Nah, it's something else. I'm going to try to open it up.
Oh.
See if I can, where did I put the scissors? Oh, wait a minute. I think I know why I put the scissors. Right over here. I wonder, where did I put the scissors? Hey. Desk.
Yeah.
And there we go.
There we go. Yep.
Everything in here.
Well.
How do you unbox and unwrap simple things? Just cut it with scissors. Just make sure you know you don't cut it. Let's see what I got in here.
Wow.
This is a Raspberry Pi micro HDMI cable. Here's the deal. My Raspberry Pi 4. I think I forgot to buy one of those cable connections to it.
Wow.
That's what it looks like. It's a Raspberry Pi. Mm-hmm. But it has the Raspberry Pi logo, I think, on it. So it's one of those things where it's the main connection, main key, main connection to the whole thing. Easy. Hold on just a second here, folks. So Sometimes you guys can ask me, how can you make something simple make it complicated? I really don't
know. Wow.
Raspberry Pi logo. I think that's what I wanted, so.
I don't know either.
So, there it is.
There it is, yep.
Alright, so let me just... I'm not going to connect the whole thing and see if it works or not. It should work, is the only thing is that... let's see.
Well... Wow.
In case we need something wrapping and something done here, you know what I mean? It's pretty cool. So everybody's been wondering, Eric. I'll talk while I'm doing this. I'll talk while I'm doing this and everything else in between. Shows. I'll tell you one thing. Like I said before, while I'm doing this, been having a lot of positive feedback on the wow. show, on the channel, and all that. Got a lot of likes, more wow. likes than expected. You know, the views. I'm not too concerned about the views, but you know what, though? Positive feedback is very, very important to me, though. I'm not gonna be super popular or anything like that. I just do this for funsies and just to share my life and to communicate with people, like I said, all over the world. Like, it was my ultimate goal. Sometimes there's people out there, they'll try to be mean to me and all that good stuff, and I know what they're up to. You know, that's probably the only thing that is smart. So. The only thing about me is that I know what people want to, and it's like, okay. Alright then, let's see. This is the, alright, this is the Raspberry Pi 4.
Wow.
I gotta see, everything's connected in. Yeah, see, this is crazy, right over here.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if, it should work. It should work. And, it's connected in.
Wow.
There we go. It's connected in. Yay! Yes. Yep, it is connected in. That's how it works.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's two of them. We don't know which one will be, but I'll figure that out when I get to it.
Yeah, which is bigger, both schools? Continue on.
I'll figure that out when I get to it.
Eric.
Figure it out? No, I'll figure that out when I get to it. I think the Raspberry Pi 4 is a lot of fun because it has two of these things, two of these bad boys.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. It's HDMI. They're both HDMI, so.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Connection. Yay. It connects. Perfect. Thank you. Thank you.
Continue on.
I cannot believe when I talked about Chad Gable. I was, Braun Strowman called Theory's phone. The question is, how do you get to Austin Theory's phone? That's what. How do you get his number? That's what I want to know. And I'm like, he must be watching Raw.
Wow.
You know, that's going to be, it's too crazy, man. Let me tell you, it's too crazy. And I was like, and then I said, oh, somebody called Chad Gable's mama.
Wow.
You know? Yeah, so the connections do work. Yeah, it's like somebody called Chad Gable's mama.
Wow.
I think Chad Gable funeral. I was like, geez, it sounds like the Undertaker must be calling him. That's how bad Chad Gable. I said, Chad Gable, you do the shushes and that. Thank you.
Wow.
It seems like to you, Mr. Gable, you gotta get those hands. You know what I mean? So this thing works. So this thing's well connected. So I'm very, very happy about that.
Wow.
So I'm just going to use my Raspberry Pi 4. Speaking of video games, gaming consoles and whatnot, I did put out an idea on the Bofus and the Sofas live chat, and because my good friend, one of the good guys on the show, Rome Latimer, aka Romy2184, mentioned Ninja Baseball Batman.
Wow.
Now they made me have to make a difficult decision to make. I got my friend Scotty, who works at the mall. He works at the Good News at the mall. He asked me if I could play a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles the arcade game in insane mode. I got Romy mentioning Ninja Baseball Batman. I may be thinking of playing that, or I'm trying to play Dragon Ball Fighters.
Wow.
And Lady Erin, Moriarty, and I'm going to try out some different fighters and everything else. You know, like I said, I'm more of a Capcom fighter guy, but I've always, you know, when I first saw Dragon Ball Fighters on Up, Up, Down, Down, and when I saw people playing, I'm like, I got to get this game, because the graphics and everything else, the gameplay is insane. Now, I'm not a big anime fan, but I know what Dragon Ball Z is all about.
Wow.
And believe me.
Believe you.
When I say this, that Dragon Ball Z has really cool, unique fighters with unique moves. Mm. And believe me, it's going to be nuts. So I was looking at this and I said, can't wait to play it. It's going to be insane in the membrane. I'll tell you one thing right now. I'll tell you what, a lot of people out there want to see me play Dragon Ball Fighters. I'll get the Switch. As a result, I got the Switch right here, I'm just really excited about this. So what I bought again is, put this thing in the middle here. There you go. What I bought again is the HDMI cable for the Raspberry Pi. Most specifically for Raspberry Pi 4. I want to see how long it is. So it's good enough. It is good enough. So let me just pull it back in. Pull it back in together.
Do you want?
Yep. So, but for right now, I don't have to worry about this because I'll be playing some. I'll be playing some games on Nintendo Switch. More importantly, Dragon Ball Fighters. That will be the next Saturday Superstar Arcade episode. That gave me an idea. But in fact, it'll be the first Saturday Superstar Arcade October 2022. That's right.
Because
this Saturday is October 2022. And, so I'm totally excited about that. That's what I'm going to do. So it's going to be really, really super cool. So I'm excited. And that's right. When I was playing around with the, Cosmic Avenger this past Saturday, the wireless controller does work. It works to perfection. So I'll be using it from that day forward. And the other Razer, and I'll tell you, man, the original Razer I bought a long time ago.
Wow.
I tried to take it apart. Not take it apart, but I tried to at least, clean all the dirt and gunk and all the hair out of it and from the beard and all. When it fell apart and I couldn't put it back together, I said, you know what, that's it, I'm gonna buy a new one. The new one works a lot better, trust me. So,
wow.
When I keep rubbing my chin, I feel so clean shaven, so it's pretty
cool. Yes.
So, that's all the time we have on the show in less than 2 hours. NXT will be coming up, as you know. Caden Carter will face Nikita Lyons. He said Nikita Lyons and Zoe Stark are going to be on the hunt for those NXT Women's Tag Team titles, being currently held by Caden Carter and Katana Chance. Will Toxic Attraction may retain them, but there's rumors out that Toxic Attraction, Gigi Dolan, JC Tanner are moving up to the main roster. And that could be, Katie could be joining up with Damage Control? We don't know. Lots of interesting storylines. Could Tegan Knox come back and join up with Damage Control? Will Candice LeRae turn against Bianca Belair, Alexa Bliss, and Asuka to join Damage Control? Who knows what, what this thing is? This whole White Rabbit thing. You're talking about a scavenger. Garrison Newkirk, a.k.a. Gare Bear, a.k.a. Mr. Garrison 96, likened this whole White Rabbit thing to a scavenger hunt. It's like a lot of clues and playing in. And we all know it's going to be Bray Wyatt and all, but it's a lot of fun the way they're doing it, they can keep us guessing. So I personally think it was really cool. I would not be surprised it would be Bray Wyatt. Who knows for sure?
Who knows,
what's going on there? Holy cow. So it's awesome. So yeah. So again, thank you for the positive feedback. John Cosan and Edric Cotto, welcome to my channel once again, gentlemen. Thank you for subscribing. Have any questions about my videos or anything like that? Please tune in. So what's on next on Doc? Okay, so I'm gonna do the NXT Event Center. I got the Joker's Wild. Wild Wednesdays, of course.
Yep.
AEW Dynamite. Could be very interesting because found out that there'll be a World Championship Eliminator matchup. John Moxley will be going up against Juice Robinson, who also is the husband of the AEW Interim Women's Champion, Tony Storm. So,
wow.
So I think that's going to be very interesting.
Wow.
Juice Robinson signs on with AEW and be with Tony Storm. Yeah, who knows?
Who knows? Yep.
Join forces and try to challenge Sammy Guevara and Ty Mello for those AAA Mixed Tag Team Championships. That's what we need, a Mixed Tag Team Division. Get all the real-life couples to team up, man. That'd be really cool.
Mm-hmm.
But might I digress. But, yeah, so that's it. That's all the time I have on the show. Once again, what did I buy? The Raspberry Pi HDMI cable from my Raspberry Pi 4. It's right here. And the coolest thing about it, it has the, you know, it has that little Raspberry Pi logo on it. Let's see. If, and a smaller one, too. I thought that was super cool. It's from Amazon, by the way.
Wow.
Yeah, I got it on Amazon. It was supposed to come in yesterday, but I think Massachusetts has some storms, storm issues, weather issues.
Wow.
So it couldn't come on time yesterday. So
yeah, wow.
I went, it'll come in tomorrow. I had a feeling because I know my friends David and Aaron, David St. Dennis and Aaron Moriarty, fellow Massachusetts natives, probably live up further north than me, talking about raining and rains and all that good stuff. But also, I pray for my friends down in Florida, man. Hurricane Ian is no joke.
Yeah, no joke, yo, because 8 months passed. You know, it's just always there. So it was scary. Continue on.
Ready to make landfall there, and I pray that you be very careful and stay safe. I pray that they stay safe up there in Florida. I feel every time you move down to Florida, hurricanes, man. I don't know. So that's it. So, you know, Nate Knight, I know he's down there in Florida. Be safe there, Nate. Please be careful while you're there.
Yes, thank you.
There, you know, you can, so we'll see what happens. So hoping everything will be okay. So we'll see what happens.
Yes.
So that's it. That's all the time we have on the show. Episode 44 of Eric Lee Shenanigans 1977 is complete. And episode 4 of Virtually Purchased Acquisitions. So, on that note, Mr. Announcer, please take us home. That is all for today's episode. This is Mr. Lima speaking for Eric Lima Shenanigans of 1977. A big beefy E, tour for Bob Saget Production, and in association with a sweet bumbling bofo raver telepictures and distribution. See you next episode, and have a very blessed day.
So that was Eric Lima Shenanigans of 1977, episode number 44, VPA, episode number 4. What do I think about this episode? I think it was amazing. So far, this episode was a success. That was Eligible Reacts episode number 1279. Hope you enjoy it. Stay tuned, the next one's going to be Eligible Reacts episode number 1280, which will be about Eric Lima Shenanigans of 1977, episode number 45, NXT Event Center for September 27th, I believe. Yes, it was 27, 2022. Now, I gotta get ready for the stream hosted by my friend Owen Nelson. And this will be Ray. Till next time, so Jarvis Bob's a baby. Move it, so just out. See ya.
Life I'll never take for granted, and given all the time I failed to really understand it, I never sought to meet the maker of reality, the one who gave the life that which is always happening. But I tried. All the time. was I the one to see things as I do under the moonlight and the sun? Perception is the question, and the giver holds the key.